back again with another video, and today I'm simply going to share with you a short behind the scenes of a photo shoot that I did recently with an amazing client of mine and also an amazing makeup artist stroke model that I work with a lot. To begin with, I thought I should start this video with a short introduction of the camera and lens combination that I used to take these images, the lighting that I use, and where we actually took these images from. And then after that, you can get into a little bit of the entertaining behind the scenes that I've prepared for you guys. Well, not many people know this, but I started my creative journey as a photographer, and I really enjoyed photography back in the days, and I still do enjoy it today. And photography is what made me become a very good videographer stroke filmmaker. But that is a story for another day. The camera setup that I used to take these images is my most used setup, which is the Sony A6400, my most favorite camera, paired with the Sigma 56mm f1.4. I didn't use any other lens to take these photos. I only used this one lens. So when it came to the lighting, I used a combination of ambient light from the sun and external flash. When I say ambient light, I mean the light that is already on the location, and mine actually came from the sun because we were shooting outdoors. The external flash that I used were the Yongnuo 560 Mark IV that are very affordable speed lights, and I used that combination to create these lovely images. When it came to controlling the flash, I used a trigger. A trigger helps me to be able to have the freedom to put the flash anywhere I want, and I'm able to trigger it even if I'm far away from the subject, and I can be able to put the speed light as close as possible to the subject. So I would really advise you to invest on such a device. That is simply the equipment that I used to take these images. I only used one camera, one lens, one speed light, and a trigger that I used to control the speed light. So you don't really need much when it comes to taking good quality images. But one other thing, I didn't do any skin retouching on these images because the client preferred them that way. She preferred the images to look as real to life as possible, but they still came out very beautiful because the client is actually that beautiful in real life. And also the makeup artist did an amazing job to primp her up and make her look amazing. The only thing that I did was color grading the images to make the colors pop and make the images look a little bit more appealing. We took these images at a famous park in Nairobi CBD by the name Arboretum. It's a very green park, very beautiful. That's why the images look as good as they are. Enough with the technicalities. Let me leave you with the behind the scenes so you can see how things actually went down during the shoot. And a reminder, each image is going to have the camera settings that I used written besides it, so you can also use them in your projects if you would love to. So enjoy the behind the scenes. And thank you for watching today's video. For the oldies, I appreciate you guys for your support. I appreciate you guys for your subscriptions, likes, and comments. And for any new person who is joining us today, if it's your first time watching my videos, please don't hesitate. Press that red subscribe button and it will be very beneficial to me. And I hope everything that I'm sharing with you guys is going to be very beneficial to you. Thank you and see you next time. Bye-bye.